I got to welcome to the show. We finally got time to get this done. Excuse me. We're going to read chapter 5, verse 9 in the book of the Bible. We're going to pray first. I'm going to pray for Grandma. She's got a cancer breakout on her face, and she's not doing too good. She's wanting prayers badly, and she's not doing very well. We got to call the doctor. She had cancer, and ain't doing very good. Pray for Daddy, get ready with these families, get ready with neighbors that are bothering you, he needs a lot of prayer, and pray for my family, pray for his family, pray for everybody's family, pray for stepdad that's in heaven right now, hopefully. His stepdad died on February 25th. They let him break his neck after going home. Later they took him home. They took him to the hospital. He was snapped and dead. Not running to his ear right now. Hold on, guys. I pray for all those praying and let them return to go to. So let's bow our heads and pray. Father, we thank you for bringing us in this particular Bible, God. Pray just get you all those prayer requests tonight, Lord, that you have in the team. Pray for what else, God. Pray for Jimmy Bradley's family, which is Cordell's dad, which is my dad. Pray for his dad, for his stepdad, his dad's stepdad, that died, and pray for all his family, and pray for my family. So thank you, Lord. Amen. Okay, let's read the Bible. Male and female created he them and blessed them, and called their name, and blessed them, Adam. In the day when they were created, and Adam lived 130 years, and begat a son of his own likeness after his image, and called his name Seth. And the days of Adam, begotten Seth for 800 years, and he begotten sons and daughters. All the days that Adam lived were 930 years, and he died, and Seth lived 105 years, and Seth begat Enoch. And Seth lived after he got his son Enos 807 years, and he got sons and daughters. All the days of Seth were 912 years, and he died. And Enos lived 90 years, and he got human or something like that. And Enos lived after he got human. Tune in 815 years, and they got sons and daughters, and all the days of Enoch were 905 years, and he died. And Kelan lived 70 years, and they got Noah. Yes. And Kelan and Paulin lived after he begot Mahalalel 840 years, and he got sons and daughters, and all the days of Kelan was 910 years, and he died. And Moari said this 60 years, and begot Jared. And Moari lived up to begot Jared 830 years, and begot sons and daughters, and all the days. Moari were 895 years, and he died. And Jared lived in 162, and begot Enosh. Yes, I guess that's what it is. And the cowboy hat, you see, it's pretty cool. I'm wearing it for my grandpa. So yeah, anyway. So, and Jared lived 162 years and begot Enosh. And Jared lived after he begot Enosh 800 years and begot sons and daughters. And all the days of Jared were 960, and 2 years he died. Enosh lived 65 years and begot Melusla. And Enosh walked with God after he begot Methuselah 300 years and begot sons and daughters. And then the were 365 years. And Enosh walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. And Methuselah lived 187 years and begot Lamech. And Methuselah lived after he begot Lamech 782 years and begot all sons and daughters. And all the days of Methuselah were 969 years, and he died. And Lamech lived 182 years and begot a son. He called his name Noah, saying, "This same all shall comfort us concerning concerning our work and toll of our hands, because of the ground which the Lord hath cursed." And Lamech lived after he begot Noah 595 years and begot sons and daughters. All the days of Lamech were 777 years and died. And Noah was 500 years old, and Noah begot Shem, Ham, and Jizim. Okay, check this out. And it came to pass when man began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of man that were fair, and took them wives for all which they choose. And the Lord said, "My spirit shall not always strive with men, for that he also is flesh, yea, he is both, shall be in 120 years. There were giants in the earth in those days, and after that," sorry guys, I did that. Anyway, in those days, after that, when the sons of God came unto the daughters of man, and they bore children to them, and the saint Almighty became my man, which were of old, man of renown. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every image and imagination that thought of his heart was only evil continually. And he reported the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and he grieved it at his heart. And the Lord said, "I will destroy man, woman I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air. For it with me that I have made them." But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was just a perfect man in his generations. Noah walked with God. Noah begot three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And the earth also was corrupt before God. And the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt. Guys, that right there is the part of what happened now. Violence, fighting, everything else. Don't listen to the narrative. Guys, don't listen to that narrative. Listen to the here. This is about the Bible. We're talking about the Bible here. We have only three chapters left to go. So, today. Anyway, listen to this Bible. We better have violence, fighting, everything on this earth. That's why it's in this Bible. So yeah, we'll keep going. The one with the and God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh, and had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Make thee an ark of gopher wood, rooms shalt thou make in the ark, and shalt pitch it within and without pitch. And this is the fashion which thou shalt make it of. The length of the ark shall be 300 cubits, the breadth of it 50 cubits, and the height of the 30 of it 30 cubits. A window shalt thou make the ark, and the cubit shalt thou finish it by both, and the door of the ark shalt thou stand the side thereof. With lower second and third story shalt thou make it. And behold, I do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh, wherein is the breathing of life from under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die. But with thee I will establish my covenant, and thou shalt come into the ark, thou and thy sons and thy wife and thy sons' wives with thee, and of every living thing of all flesh, two of every sort shalt thou bring into the ark to keep them alive, and with thee they shall be male and female, of fowls after their kind, and of cattle after their kind. Sorry guys, I'm doing that crap again. Anyway, of every creeping thing of the earth, after this time, two of every sort shall come unto thee to keep them alive. And take thou unto thee of all food that is eaten, and thou shalt gather it to thee, and it shall be for food for thee and for them. Thus did Noah, according to all that God commanded him, for the heat. Chapter 7. And the Lord said unto Noah, come thou and all thy house into the ark for thee, seeing I see righteousness before me in this generation. Of every clean beast thou shalt take to thee by sevens, the male and female of the beasts that are not clean by two, the male and his female, of fowls also of the air by sevens, and the male and the female to keep seed alive upon the face of all the earth. For yet 7 days, and I will cause it to rain upon the earth 40 days and 40 nights. And every living substance that I have made will I destroy it from off the face of the earth. And did Noah according unto all that the Lord commanded him. And Noah was 600 years old when the floods of water was upon the earth. Noah went in, his sons and his wife and his sons' wives with him into the ark because of the waters of the flood. Of clean beasts, and of beasts that are not clean, of fowls, and that everything that creepeth upon the earth. There went in two and two unto Noah into the ark, the male and the female, as God had commanded Noah. And it came to pass after 7 days that the waters of the flood were upon the earth. It's the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 7th day of the month, the same day were all the fountains of great deep broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened. And the rain was upon the earth 40 days and 40 nights. And the selfsame day entered Noah, and the Shem and Ham, Japheth, the sons of Noah, and Noah's wives, and the three wives of his sons with them into the ark. Saying, and every beast after his kind, and all the cattle after their kind, and every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth after his kind, and every fowl after his kind, every bird at every sort. And they went unto Noah into the ark, two and two of flesh, of all planets wherein is the breeders of life. And they stood that within male and female of all planets as God had commanded him, and the Lord shut him in. And the flood was 40 days upon the earth, and the waters increased and bar up the ark, and it was lifted up above the earth, and the waters prevailed and were increased greatly upon the earth, and the ark went upon the face of the waters, and the waters prevailed exceedingly upon the earth, and all the high hills that were under the whole heaven were covered 15 cubits upward did the waters prevail, and the mountains were covered. And all flesh died that moved upon the earth, bone, fowl, of cattle, and of beasts, and of every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth, and of a man. All in the whose nostrils was the breathing of life, and all was that was in the dry land died. Every living substance was destroyed which was upon the face of the ground, both man and cattle, and the creeping things. After the fowl of the heaven, they were destroyed from the earth, and Noah was only remained alive. They were with him in the ark. And the waters prevailed upon the earth in 150 days. Chapter 8. And God remembered Noah that, and every living thing, and all the cattle that was with him in the ark. And God made a wind to pass over the earth, and the waters assuaged the fountains also of the deep, and their windows of heaven were stopped, and the rain from heaven was restrained, and the waters returned from all the earth continually. And after the end of the 150 days, the waters were abandoned, and the ark rested in the seventh month, and on the 17th day of the month, upon the mountains of Ararat. Alright, and the waters decreased continually until the 10th month, and the 10th month on the first day of the month were the tops of the mountain seen. And it came to pass at the end of 40 days that Noah opened the window of the ark which he had made, and he sent forth a raven which went forth to and forth from until the waters were dried up from off the earth. Also he sent forth a dove from him to see if the waters were abandoned from off the face of the ground. But the dove found no rest for the sole of her foot, and she returned unto him into the ark, because the waters were on the face of the whole earth. Then he put forth his hand and took her and pulled her unto him into the ark. He stayed yet another 7 days, and again he sent forth the dove out of the ark, and the dove came into him in the evening, and lo, in her mouth was an olive leaf. Okay, olive leaf. What? Also, no one knew that the waters were abandoned from off the earth, and he stayed yet another 7 days, and sent forth, and the dove it returned not again unto him any more. And it came to pass in the 601st year, in the first month, the first day of the month, and the waters were dried up from the off the earth. And Noah removed the covering of the ark, and looked, and behold, the face of the ground was dry. And in the second month, on the 7th and the 20th day of his month, was the earth dried. And God spake unto Noah, saying, go forth to the ark, thou and thy wife, and thy sons, and thy son's wife with thee, bring forth with thee every living thing that is with thee of all flesh, both of fowl and of cattle, and of every creeping thing that is that creepeth upon the earth, that they may breed abundantly in the earth and be fruitful. Wait, that's the one. Oh yeah, it is. Every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth, that they may breed abundantly in the earth, and be fruitful and multiply upon the earth. And Noah went forth, and his sons and his wives, and his sons' wives with him. Every beast, every creeping thing, and every fowl, and whatsoever creepeth upon the earth after their times, and went forth of the ark. And Noah built an altar unto the Lord, and took up every clean beast, and up every clean fowl, and offered burnt offerings on the altar. And the Lord smelled a sweet savior, and the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground any more for man's sake, for the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth. Neither will I again send it any more everything living as I have done. While the earth remains seed time and harvest and cold and heat and summer and winter and day and night shall not cease. And God blessed Noah and his sons and said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish their earth. That's the end of this chapter. We'll do longer. We'll do some more longer later in the videos. See y'all later. Till then, next time on another Bible video. See you later.